Hello everyone, myself Ankur Patel, and today in this fourth session of projection of lines, we will continue our practice with problems of projection of lines. So let's start with the first problem. A line AB is 65 mm long, appears to be 45 mm in plan and 55 mm in elevation. Its end A is 20 mm below HP, 40 mm behind VP. Draw projection of line and find the true angle of inclination of the line with HP and VP. So the given data is two length is given 65 mm. Plan length is given 45 mm, so plan length is 45 mm, 55 mm in elevation, that means the elevation length is 55 mm, and A is 20 mm below HP, 40 mm behind VP, so and A is 20 mm below HP and 40 mm behind VP. Right now, and A is in the third quadrant, and we have to find out the true angle of inclination of the line with the HP and VP, that is theta and phi. So right now, the quadrant of point B or locus of point B is not given. So first of all, we have to assume the quadrant of point B. So as the point A is in the third quadrant, we will assume point B in the third quadrant as. So by assuming point B in the third quadrant, let's try. Let's start the problem. So first of all, draw XY reference line. After drawing the XY reference line, first of all, draw plan and elevation of point A, because the locus of point A is given. So A is 20 mm below HP. So 20 mm below the XY reference line, we will get elevation of point A. So this will be the locus of A dash. And 40 mm behind VP, that means 40 mm above the XY reference line, we will get plan of point A. So this will be the plan of point A, draw locus from point A, this will be the locus of A. Now here the other given data is two length, PL and EL. So let's try to draw TL, PL and EL. So first of all, take true length. So true length is 65 mm, and as we know that we can draw true length from A and A dash. But right now, if you want to draw true length, theta and phi are required, or locus of B and B dash are required. So theta and phi are not given, and locus of B dash and B is not given, so we cannot draw true length right now. So let's try to draw plan length. So if you want to draw plan length, we can draw plan length from A, but right now we doesn't have a beta angle to draw or to show plan length, and we doesn't have the locus to get the arc on the locus of B. So right now we doesn't draw the plan length also. Elevation length is 55 mm, so we can draw elevation from A dash, but if you want to draw show elevation, alpha angle is required or locus of B dash is required, which is also not given. So what will we do? So if you analyze the further problems, you can understand that if we mark B2 on locus of A, and if we measure a distance between A B2, we will get plan length. So we can mark plan length on locus of A to get B2. So measure plan length 45 mm and mark B2 on locus of A. This length will be the plan length, but it is not a plan of line AB. Now as we have marked the plan on locus of A, we can mark elevation on locus of A dash. So measure elevation length, which is 55 mm, and from A dash measure 55 mm, you get B2 dash. So right now we have B2 and B2 dash. Now draw straight line from B2 dash in the direction of locus of B, and from B2 draw a straight line in the direction of locus of B dash. Right now we have assumed the point B in the third quadrant, so we will get plan of point B above the XY reference line and elevation of point B below the XY reference line. And on this projector you will get B1, and on this projector you will get B1 dash, which will gives us the true line. And we have the true length, so measure true length 65 mm, take center at A and give an arc on this projector, you will get B1. This will be the locus of B and B1, and by connecting B1 to A, we will get the true length, which is inclined at an angle of phi. So phi is the angle of inclination of the line with the vertical plane. Now again we have a true length 65 mm, so from A dash give an arc on this projector, you will get B1 dash. This will be the locus of B dash and B1 dash. Connect B1 dash to A dash, we will get true length inclined at angle of theta. Now if you want to find out the plan, measure AB2, which is 45 mm, on the rounder, take center at A and rotate B2 up to locus of B. Here we will get B, and by connecting B2 to A, we will get the plan and the angle beta. And rotate A dash B2 dash, which is our elevation length, up to locus of B dash by taking center at A dash. So take center at a dash, a dash is equal to a dash to b2 dash, given a couple locus of b dash. Here we will get b dash. Now connect b dash to a dash, we will get the elevation length, and the angle of elevation length is alpha. Now we have to find out the theta and phi, but first of all connect b dash b, we will get the end projectors. Now we have to find out the theta and phi, so measure theta and phi and write down the answer by your own. Now let's move on to next example. The front view and top view of line MN is inclined at an angle of 30 degree and 40 degrees respectively. The front view of a line MN measures 50 mm. Point M is 15 mm above HP, 10 mm in front of it. Draw the projection of line MN and find the true length of the line MN. So the given data is the front view and top view of line MN is inclined at an angle of 30 degree and 40 degree. So this 30 degree and 40 degree is our alpha and beta, and front view measures 50 mm. So elevation length is 50 mm, alpha is 30 degree, beta is 40 degree, and front view measures 50 mm, that means elevation length is 50 mm. Point M is 15 mm above HP, 10 mm in front of VP. Point M is 15 mm above HP, 10 mm in front of VP. Draw the projection of the line MN and find the true length of the line MN. So here we have to find out the true length only, which we will find after drawing the projections. Now here again the quadrant of point N is not given, or locus of point N is not given. So first thing is we have to assume the quadrant of point N. And as M is in the first quadrant, we will assume point N in the first quadrant also. So assume point N in the first quadrant. So N will be above HP and in front of VP. Now let's try to solve this example by using this data. So first of all, draw XY reference line. After drawing the XY reference line, mark point M. That means mark elevation and plan of point M. So M is 15 mm above HP and 10 mm in front of VP. So 15 mm above, that means 15 mm above the XY reference line, we will get M dash. Draw the locus of M dash from M dash, and 10 mm in front of VP. In front of, that means 10 mm below the XY reference line, we will get the plan of point M. Draw the locus of M from M. Now we have alpha, beta, elevation length. So let's start with the elevation length, 50 mm. And as we know that we can mark elevation length on locus of M dash, we will get N2 dash. So from M dash measure 50 mm, and this is our elevation length. Here we will get N2 dash. So now we have N2 dash and we have elevation length, and we also have the angle of the elevation length, which is alpha. So first of all, rotate M dash and N2 dash, or take center at M dash and radius is equal to M dash to N2 dash. Draw an arc in the upward direction, because we will get N dash above the XY reference line, because we have assumed N in the first quadrant. Now from M dash, draw a line inclined at an angle of alpha, which is 30 degree. So draw a line inclined at an angle of alpha, which is 30 degree. We will get the intersection of this line on this arc. This will be our N dash, and N dash M dash will be our elevation length, which is 50 mm. Now draw locus of N dash and N1 dash. So on this locus we will get N1 dash also. Now we have a beta angle, which is the angle of the plan length, that is MN. And if we draw a projector from N dash, or we will draw projector of N, we will get plan of point N somewhere below the XY reference line on this projector. So if you want to find out N, now draw a line inclined at an angle of 40 degree from M. So draw a line inclined at an angle of 40 degree from M. These are our N projectors, 40 degree, which is beta. Here we will get N. So MN is our plan length, and the angle is already given, which is 40 degree. This is the locus of N1 and N. Now if you want to find out the true length, we have to draw a straight line from N2 dash up to locus of N. So draw a straight line from N2 dash up to locus of N. Here we will get N1, and by connecting N1 to M, this will be our true length at an angle of phi. Now measure this true length, M N1. Put your rounder on M dash, or take M dash as a center and give an arc on locus of N dash. Here we will get N1 dash. Connect M1 dash, sorry, M dash and N1 dash, we will get true length, and angle of this true length is theta. Now we have to find out the true length of the line MN. So measure this true length M dash N1 dash or MN, it will be equal to 62 mm. So this is our final answer. Now let's move on to next example. A line AB 90 mm long is inclined at 30 degree to HP. Its end is 12 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of PP. Its front view measures 65 mm. Draw the top view of AB and state its length. Determine the inclination of the top view and line AB with vertical plane. So here given data is true length is given, which is 90 mm. And the angle of the true length is also given, 30 degree with the horizontal plane, so theta is 30 degree. And A is 12 mm above HP, 20 mm in front of AB. And the elevation length is 65 mm. Front view is 65 mm, so elevation length is 65 mm. With end A, 12 mm above HP, 20 mm in front of VP. And we have to find out the top view of the line or length of the top view of the line. So we have to find out the plan length, and we have to find out the inclination of the top view with the XY reference line. That means we have to find out the beta, and line AB with the vertical bend. That means we have to find out the phi also. And here again, the quadrant of point B is not given. So first thing is we have to assume the quadrant of point B. And here the point A is in the first quadrant, so we will assume point B in the first quadrant also. So B is in the first quadrant, so it will be above HP in front of VP. So let's start. So first of all, draw XY reference line. After drawing the XY reference line, first thing is we have to mark the plan and elevation of point A, because the locus of A is given. So A is 12 mm above HP. So above the XY reference line, 12 mm, we will get A dash, and draw locus of A dash from A dash. And 20 mm in front of VP, that means 20 mm below the XY reference line, we will get the plan of point A. So mark point A or plan of point A, this will be the locus of A. After marking elevation and plan of point A, now let's try to solve the examples by using this given data, that is true length, theta and elevation length. Now true length is given and theta is given. So theta is the angle of the true length, and we can draw theta from A dash. So from A dash, draw a line inclined at angle of theta, which is 30 degree, having length equal to 90 mm. So we will get true length. Here we will get B1 dash, draw locus of B1 dash. This is the locus of B dash also. Now we have elevation length. And as you know that elevation length is A dash, B dash. And right now we have locus of B dash also. So measure elevation length 65 mm. Take center at A dash and give an upon locus of B dash. Here we will get B dash. By connecting B dash to A dash, we will get the elevation at an angle of alpha. Now we have to find out the plan length, beta and phi. So first thing is draw the end projectors. That is from B dash, draw a straight line. This is my end projectors. And now from B1 dash, draw a straight line up to locus of A. Here we will get B2. And this length will indicate the plan length. So right now we have the plan of point A, but we doesn't have the plan of point B. So if you want to find out the plan of point B, take center at A, radius is equal to A to B2, which is equal to the plan length, give an arc on this projector. So here we will get B. So connect B to A, this will be the locus of B and B1. Connect B to A, this will be our plan length at an angle of beta. Now measure true length, which is A dash B1 dash, or take an arc of 90 mm on this locus from A. So from A, take an arc of 90 mm on locus of B. So here we will get B1, and by connecting B1 to A, we will get true length and the angle of the true length with the vertical plane, which is phi. Now measure the plan length, which will be equal to 78 mm. Measure the beta angle by using the protractor, we will get beta is equal to 53 degree. Measure the phi angle by using the protractor, we will get phi is equal to 44 degree. So this will be our final answer. So this is it for today. Thank you for watching. We will come with some more problems of projection of lines in our next lecture. Till then, take care.